first of all, I would not try to judge whether the Germans setting down 7 plants was the appropriate thing. They need to make that decision. I think it's important to separate out different activities. One is sort of the immediate response, both by industry and by government, was to do what they call re-verify. Go back and check. Are you ready to deal with a flood? Are you ready to deal with science? Are you ready to deal with loss of all electric power? The kinds of things that happen in Japan. Now, that's just a let's make sure we're on the ball with what we're doing. The question you're asking is really more broadly, well, now, policy-wise, what's going to be the consequences? And, of course, it's very early to speculate, and I don't consider myself enough of a technical expert to sort of pronounce on those things, but let me suggest some things that I think are likely to happen on policy. One is it's very clear, the NRC has already made it clear, they're going to go back to the drawing board on the seismic calculations for the various power plants around the country. And there are a number of them that are in earthquake zones but are usually considered quite minor earthquakes. And so the plants have been built to and designed to take it kind of proposition. But now, with Fukushima having been miscalculated, that's going to be recalculated in the United States. And certainly a couple of power plants have already been targeted in news media and others as maybe in high probability zones. And so one possibility is that they, over time, would get shut down. I'm not saying they will, but clearly that analysis is going to be done. Plus, the follow-up analysis of, are we really prepared for a serious event in terms of emergency preparedness and how you would manage it? Another question, of course, is the as I've already alluded to, the how much you pack into a spent fuel pool, and that may lead to a policy change that affects a number of power plants. There are, in the United States, we've been going through a process called license extension. The original license to operate for a power plant in this country is 40 years. That wasn't based on anybody's knowledge as to whether the plant would seriously deteriorate or not. It was just the picked original arbitrary date of 40 years. And power plants have been going in, I think some 40 or more, have already achieved what is called a license extension for another 20 years, which will allow them to operate 20 years. They often are making big investments. They, of course, they're continually upgrading their equipment anyway, kind of proposition. But there are a number now power plants that have these applications in, and I would suspect they're going to be challenged more by local people and stuff in certain cases. Already one, Diablo Canyon on the West Coast, even the utility has said, hold up, don't make the decision yet. We want to do more seismic analysis before you make the final decision on whether we can extend the life of this power plant. So that's another decision point at which we may see some actions that could occur. And there are a variety of these. For example, we may have the whole issue of instrumentation. How do we know what is happening inside that reactor? How do we know what's happening in that spent fuel pool, especially if we have a situation like Japan where we lost power, we couldn't get inspectors up into the fuel pools to see what was going on. And so instrumentation and whether we need more backup instrumentation, whether you need more practical, it's not related to electricity at all, kinds of things. Just a bopper, a thing that will tell you the water is going down or up and will signal you, kind of thing. So there are multiple ways in which that may, these kind of policy questions will go forward.